Greetings and welcome to our program, The Starting Point. We are so grateful that you've got in touch with us. It's a blessing, as usual, to make sure that we can connect and encourage one another. So this is a beautiful day, and I want to thank you for tuning in, either on Facebook or Instagram or YouTube, so whatever you connected. We are just so grateful that you are there to be able to interact with us. So this day is I want to be sharing a little bit more about our need to make sure that in all relationships there's just no chance, no way that it can actually prosper unless we are actually connected with God. Now God is the starting point. Believe me or not, God is the starting point. I mean, like, if we don't have any connection with the foundation of all information, foundation of all life, then there's just no chance that things will be going that very well. You know, we don't sometimes realize that even in marriage relationships or just casual relationships, we just need the element of God in all that. All those kind of relationships to be able to work. Because if it's not there, and if we can only become wise in our own eyes and maybe try to fix it and maybe try to do it the way we think it's right, in most cases we are ending up in disaster. And I know relationships sometimes start so well. You know, it is so appealing sometimes, like when people are starting relationships. But you know, it all ends up in disaster. Why? Because we are trying to do it in our own way. We are trying to do it in our own wisdom, in our own understanding. But you see, the understanding that really works, or the wisdom that really works, is the wisdom of God. Our wisdom can easily be corrupted because we can easily be exposed to a lot of information, deceptive spirits, deceptive whatever, you know, influences that can actually make our lives different. So, but we're going to be looking back again to the book of the first book of Samuel, which talks about how it all began. I mean, like, how things have not been going on well for people in leadership, in governments, and in churches, even in marriages or just casual relationships with people. You know, it's supposed to be a very loving and fulfilling relationship between man and man, or woman and woman, or man and woman. I mean, in a way of friendship and a way of family. That's what I'm talking about. It's supposed to be something that we really enjoy. We should be enjoying our families. But today, we see a lot of families which are so disintegrated. I mean, people are living so many miles apart. Why? Because for some reason, they have probably maybe annoyed each other or abused each other. And I'll be trying to discuss a little bit about this kind of abusive relationships where we find children in homes can't live happily anymore. Or even parents are not comfortable with their children. Husbands are not comfortable with their wives. Wives are not comfortable with their husbands. Or relatives, mother-in-law, father-in-law, you know, aunties and uncles. You know, why does that happen? Because it's not supposed to be like that in any way. I mean, we are supposed to be enjoying the fellowship. And guess what? When we hear about the end, or maybe when we part from this world, I mean, when we go to heaven, all is going to be joy. I believe that with all my heart. It's all going to be joy because that was the foundation. That means we'll be back into the fellowship of our Father, and things are going to be different. So in our next episodes, we'll be talking more about, you know, how to build a healthy relationship. But you know, when you have a good foundation in God, definitely you are going to enjoy your relationship with other people, you know, because that's the starting point. And if it's the starting point, you know, marriages shouldn't fail. I've personally been married for 24 years. I mean, like, there have been challenges, but you know what? There is no family anywhere in the world that doesn't necessarily face challenges. Because as long as we are still on earth, and as long as we are probably experiencing a little bit of the fallen nature in us, we are going to be having issues. between one another. And it's like, you know, you start off well, but down the line when you have some challenges, you realize probably you're not meant for each other. That's not true. It's a deceptive spirit. That's a lie. So when we begin to talk about good relationship, we must make sure that God is in the picture, is in the picture of our lives, of our hearts, that we have given our hearts to God. We have given our minds and we've given everything. It's like we've surrendered all our lives to be used by God, because God will actually reach out to other people, will reach out to your neighbor, to reach out to your family through you when you have actually opened up your heart, you've opened up your mind, so that even the issue of forgiving, it only comes by grace. Because in most cases, when you want to forgive somebody, sometimes, like, because you're living alone, you think forgiveness is something that is in your power, just to do it when you want to, and you just, no, it's not like that. Forgiveness, that's a command from the Lord. And you know what? God gives grace to be able to forgive people. And that's why, if you are living happily at any point in your life, you must be applying those principles in your life, the principles of God, godly principles, to make things work. I mean, like, sometimes we use elements, or rather the principles of God, or the principles in the Bible, to do things that we can be so successful just because we have used those principles. It's like when we give, somebody might be so evil, but if they are able to give, you know what? That principle of giving works. So if it works, because it's just because there's God in it. There's God in that principle. Godly principles work for almost anybody. And you see, when we apply them, it's like it's faith, like faith. When you believe in God, if you just have faith in God, that's why people who have faith in God and they really, really desire that God will touch their lives, you know, it doesn't even matter what kind of religion they have. But one thing is, if they believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God, I mean, like, by faith and receive the healing. I've seen that in meetings where, you know, people with different religion and they don't even believe in Jesus Christ. But because on that day, that moment, if they say, well, Jesus Christ is my Lord and I would like him to touch me, he's so merciful. He touches them. He heals them. But you see, healing shouldn't necessarily be something that will overshadow the fact that you have to develop a relationship with Christ himself. So then we'll be discussing, and you know, as we go along, issues that normally come as a result of just being away from God, away from the principles of God, that will help you to build a healthy relationship with your wife, a healthy relationship with your friends, good working relationship. Because you can have issues even at work with your bosses, with your fellow workers, but you know, it all comes down to our selfishness, our being in a position not to connect with God, not to see the other person in the image of God, and not even to realize that actually, if we don't necessarily obey God, if we don't necessarily go according to the principle, things are not going to be that easy even in your working relationships. You'll be abandoned. Some of you, as I speak, right, you've been thrown out of your job. I mean, you've been thrown because you're not cooperating. You're not necessarily submissive. You're actually even find difficulty in submitting to anybody. So then they will probably throw you out from your business or from whichever position or whichever work you're doing. You know, that all comes down to the fact that, you know, if we are not necessarily working with God, there are things that we shall face in life. And because there are other people who are in a fallen nature like yourself, who will also behave and know that, you know, they can just throw you out of your job, they can only just terminate you, they can write you off, you know, it's like give you a termination letter just like that, because they have the authority, they have the power. But I want to talk about how we can even use the authority that God gives us, so that we can even manage well, that we can respect even our workers. We respect our bosses, but also even as bosses, it's like we respect the people that work with us. So it's not just, you know, our life is supposed to be so connected. Even at work, I mean, we're not supposed to be bossing over others in a way that almost abuses them. I mean, like, it's more of an abusive leadership. It's more of kind of intimidating leadership, dictatorship. Well, it seemed to be like when you're a boss, so you are so important that everybody will be on their knees. You know, whatever you say, you just, you know, like, you can shut down on them, you can't do anything. That's not the way it's supposed to be. It's supposed to be a loving. I believe with all my heart. It's supposed to be, even in companies, it's supposed to be a loving relationship. In governments, you know, wherever it is, wherever the people involved, I mean, like, it should be a very loving relationship. So we'll be talking about issues, especially based on this fact that God told us that if we are going to choose men to be our leaders, in the sense that we look to men as being our leaders, looking to people as being, you know, it's like our main examples. It's like they are our standard. No. The thing is, if we have leaders, yes, but the leaders must be leaders that obey God, that look to God. They look to God all the time for wisdom, for ways, for knowledge, for understanding, in order to do a better job, whatever they are. So it will be, I believe it's going to take us quite a while, so do not forget to connect with us, because we'll be having various areas that we'll be touching, because I've been touching about abusive relationships, I've been talking about how to build healthy relationships, and I'll be talking about dating or courting, and how we can respect boundaries, how we can live a life that just is so good that you can even have friends. You know, like, can we be friends? Yes, it's possible that we can be friends, just good friends, and not necessarily taking it to levels where they're not supposed to be. And I want to be sharing with you about how you can actually have wonderful relationships even with the opposite sex. It's like people that you respect and you have nice, well, good, defined boundaries where you don't necessarily have to mess each other up, and then like you break up even after you started so well. You know, I want to make sure that you can live a good life with the other people, and live in a good relationship with other people. Those that are not even meant to be married shouldn't get married. I mean, like, if you are not every relationship actually should end up in marriage. And not all friendships should always lead to that, what we call it, another level. You know, I want us to realize that we can actually maintain and have friends all over the world. I mean, like, friends everywhere. Just a flood of them. I mean, like, just a whole sea of friends who are supposed to be giving you healthy support. So I'll be talking about casual friendships and how we can actually acquire a healthy marriage and also live through that, not because there are no hiccups and all those kind of shortfalls, and, you know, they just knowing how to navigate around it so that you can actually live happily with your wife. I mean, like, why not? But if it is also just about friendship and being able to maintain and have even favor before your bosses at work, I'm sure that is still quite possible. But you know what? It comes down to where God has warned us in 1 Samuel chapter 8. I've taken this very seriously because I know as long as we don't necessarily recognize God in our lives in any situation, to be honest with you, things will not be well, because God said it. So in 1 Samuel, we'll be basing that as one of our main theme, where he says that, you know, they have chosen down king, they have decided to reject me as their leader, but they will have challenges. Somebody will be oppressing them, somebody will assume a lot of things that's supposed to be done for them, especially if they're in kind of a leadership position. They'll always be thinking, you should be doing this for me. If you don't do that for me, I'll chuck you out, I'll do this to you. You know, like, even in relationship, husbands will be assuming too much authority. Even in, you know, women are supposed to submit in a certain way, which is again more abusive sometimes. So we want to look at the levels. We shall be looking at the levels. So please tune in and don't forget to subscribe, because we'll be able to discuss a lot of issues that will help you to grow in relationship. And I believe for many of you who are maybe like singles, don't think that's a curse. It's not necessarily a curse. If it is a curse, we'll see how we can go around that. But I believe many people, as we listen to this program, will be married this year. I promise you. Because they will be seeing the possibility of doing that in such a very healthy way. And that will normally not even put you in a position where you're thinking too much, know, husbands are difficult, women are difficult, some of you have even given up in a relationship, but I believe you're going to be encouraged and you probably are going back into your relationship, your healthy relationship, and build again. So do not give up even when you have had a broken relationship. That is a way of mending it that up. I promise you. And I believe these things are going to be different. Before the end of the year, I promise you, especially for those of you who are really looking forward to getting married and getting relationships, things are going to be better and easier, and you'll be surprised. I promise you. May the Lord bless you. Do not forget to feed Him. God bless.